And while you're in that record shop, you might as well stock up on Les Noces, which is maybe Stravinsky's greatest work, except for 10 or 12 others. That's how it is with Stravinsky's music. It's like Schubert's songs or Mozart piano concertos. Whichever one you're listening to is the greatest one of all. You listen to the Symphony of Psalms. Of course, it's his greatest work, maybe the greatest of the century. And then you listen to Le Sacre du Printemps, same thing. Ah, but Oedipus Rex. What about Thraney? You forgot Histoire des Soldats. Always the same thing, the greatest. And so it is also with Les Noces, the wedding, a combination choral cantata ballet about a Russian peasant wedding, which I can't tell you about, defies description. Just go listen to it. But let me play a snatch of the opening scene for you, a strangely cruel and hurtful music that accompanies the ritual braiding of the young bride's hair by her girl companions. Now, what makes that so barbarously cruel? It's the same bitonality as in the Sacre example, this one, only with the tonalities exchanged. Instead of this dissonance, it's this one. And this acid dissonance is mirrored in the rhythmic dissonance of the irregular meters. You see how this sharply accentuated distortion of meter adds to the feeling of cruelty and pain just as strongly as did the bitonal dissonance. And exactly like that barbaric passage in Le Sacre, where every accent comes at you like a body blow, always hitting when you least expect it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Left hook, right jab.